Our next guest has been an international singing star for a decade already, although she's still only 25 years old.
Yes, unbelievable. She started out busking, would you believe, in her native New Zealand, but she is now her country's most successful ever recording artist. Please give a big Belfast welcome to Hayley Westenra.
How is everyone tonight? It's so, so wonderful just to be here with you all in Belfast at this very iconic place on such a beautiful evening. Now I'm really, really thrilled to be back. I've been here a few times and so I'm feeling quite at home here. So, this next song is another one from my album, my latest album, Paradiso, one I made with the film composer Ennio Morricone. And it's a tribute to the Portuguese fado singer Amália Rodrigues, and it's called Amália por Amor.
Pelo
The haunting emotion of the Portuguese fado and the music of Ennio Morricone, the only man I've ever seen at the Waterfront Hall to get a standing ovation of about 10 minutes when he walked onto the stage at the beginning of the concert. A popular man. Hayley's a popular girl too. And you know what? I think if we give her a big enough clap, she might come back and give us another one. What do you think? I thought so.
There are dreams that cannot be.
Thank you.
Not so fast. Wonderful. We're going to have a little chat now. Until we go, yes, did we not tell you?
No, I forgot about that.
Until we go back to the Albert Hall. Hayley, tell me about this connection with Ennio Morricone. He was a hugely popular man in Northern Ireland. So how did you come to be tied up with him?
Well, about 5 years ago, he played my album, apparently, and he liked my voice. And so I went over to Sicily to meet him. And the idea was that we were going to work on a collaboration together. And then 5 years or 4 years later, we ended up doing a whole album together. So it was just amazing being out in Rome with him in his studio, with his orchestra and just his...
His following is extraordinary, isn't it?
Yeah, no, it is. And it was just, you know, we're spending all that time with, you know, such a musical genius. It was just pretty surreal, actually.
Did I read that you wrote the lyrics to that Gabriel's Oboe song that you sang first?
Yeah, I did. I wrote some lyrics to one of the songs, and then he was like, write some more, so I did. And then Don Black and Sir Tim Rice also contributed lyrics. So the whole project was just, you know, it was pretty amazing.
And will this collaboration continue with Morricone?
Yeah, I mean, I hope so. I know he's off doing a lot of concerts at the moment, and hopefully our paths will cross again. But, you know, I have this wonderful album and these wonderful arrangements and pieces to carry with me, so I'm very happy with that.
Now, your first album, which came out when you were 16 years old, was, I think, the fastest selling classical album ever. Or there's some amazing statistics surrounding it.
Yes.
You look, you're 25 now. I mean, you're clearly aging. He said gallantly, you know what I mean. You know, when you look back at that 16-year-old, what do you think?
I think from now on, let's just leave the age out, you know. when I was younger, I kind of took everything in my stride, and I didn't really stop. I didn't really have time to stop and take it all in. So now I'm, you know, definitely, you know, appreciating every opportunity, you know, more, and just making sure I sort of, you know, take photos and remember things otherwise.
Take time to relax.
It's basically a blur. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So just kind of take it at a slightly slower pace.
And I mean, you must, when it started, when you were 16, I mean, you must have been like rushed off your feet the whole time.
Yeah. I spent about 4 years just living out of a suitcase, really. And it was interesting. It was fun. It was, I missed my family, of course. I've kind of got a nice, happy balance. So.
And you're living in Gay Paris?
I am. Yeah. Yes, I am.
That's a bit of a culture shock from New Zealand.
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah. but you know, it's every kind of girl's dream to live there. So I'm pretty happy there.
Okay. And we talked yesterday about your voice changes, obviously, as you grow, as you mature. Mm. Let's use that expression instead, shall we? Yeah. So how do you feel your voice progressing? What are your musical ambitions?
As I'm getting older, I'm able to do more with my voice, so I'm kind of enjoying it more. And, you know, in my concerts, you know, I'm kind of going from classical to pop and a bit of folk, and so I'm really enjoying exploring music, and then my voice is able to kind of explore that music with me, so that's what I'm enjoying about the age.
The age.
The aging.
The music of the age. Hayley Westenra, thank you very much indeed. It's wonderful to have you back in Belfast.